thanks to the discovery of the Higgs boson, we now know that the universe is filled with an invisible substance known as the Higgs field. And crucially, this Higgs field is responsible for giving mass to the fundamental particles that make up everything in the world around us, including you and me. So what would happen if the Higgs field switched off? Well, the short answer is it would be bad. Very, very bad. Let's start with the good old atom, the basic building block of all the stuff in the universe. Now, an atom is made of fundamental particles called electrons in orbit around a tiny positively charged nucleus. The electron is a fundamental particle, which means it gets its mass from the Higgs field. So if we turn the Higgs field off, that means the electron suddenly becomes massless. Now, this is a big problem because the average distance that the electron is from the nucleus, in other words, the size of the atom, depends on the mass of the electron. And if the mass of the electron goes to zero, the size of the atom goes to infinity. In other words, atoms disintegrate and all the stuff in the universe around us will fall apart. Now, the total disintegration of all structure in the universe is pretty bad, I'm sure you'd agree. But something else will happen as well, something slightly more subtle, but equally unpleasant. And it's to do with the basic building blocks of the atomic nucleus, protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons are made of fundamental particles called quarks. A proton is made of two up quarks and a down quark, and the neutron is made of two down quarks and an up quark. Now, in our universe, the neutron is ever so slightly heavier than the proton. And this is ultimately due to the fact that the down quark is slightly heavier than the up quark, which is just enough to tip the scales in the neutron's favor. So if the Higgs field switched off, the down quark and the up quark would both become massless. And the upshot of this is that the proton would actually end up slightly heavier than the neutron. Boring footnote. An important thing to realize is that actually most of the mass of the proton and the neutron doesn't come from the mass of the quarks inside them. It actually comes from the strong nuclear force that binds the quarks together. So even if quarks are massless, the proton and the neutron still have a mass. Now, protons being heavier than neutrons is bad because this now means that protons can decay into neutrons. In fact, because of the way the Higgs field changes the form of the fundamental forces in this universe, actually protons will decay almost instantaneously into neutrons, meaning that there's no hydrogen in this universe, which is of course one of the basic building blocks of life. There are a bunch of other consequences too. The forces that we know and love would completely change in form. The fundamental particles that we know about would all rearrange themselves. Basically, the ingredients of this universe would look nothing like the one we live in, and it certainly wouldn't be somewhere that we could live. So I guess we should all be pretty grateful that the Higgs field is around and that it has this nice Goldilocks value that allows atoms to form and therefore wobbly, flesh-colored things made of atoms like us. If you've enjoyed this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you'd like to find out more about particle physics and our ongoing quest to understand the physical stuff of our universe, then you can read about it in my upcoming book, How to Make an Apple Pie from Scratch, published this August. And you can pre-order a copy by clicking a link in the description.